Monday. And oh my god, with you nerds in chat room complaining about being late, this might be the closest we've been to being on time in the 13 months that this has been a thing. So, look at that. I need mods. Hopefully I have mods in chat tonight, because I know I saw Nyx earlier and I saw Rennie earlier, I think. Both of you guys, if you're here, be on your best lookout, because I'm expecting lots of trolls and lots of shenanigan-y behaviors in the chat room. All kinds of not family-appropriate things. So, swords ready, mods. That's why you have them. I'm going to pull up my list real quick. It says that Rennie and Nyx are both here. So, that's A+. Do-do-do, I've left these nerds on hold for so long. Should I keep them on hold? We have some very special guests tonight, people. We have guests that were made possible this evening by you in the community. Guests that would have never, ever, ever in a bajillion years would these guests... Uh-oh, guys. Do we have problems? We might have trouble. We might have trouble. We might have Mayday. We might have Maydays. Boop boop.
What?
Alright.
Motherfucker.
We had slight troubles. We're having slight troubles right now. I'm watching frames be dropping on stream. So it doesn't look horrible, but we're gonna try to push through it as best we can. Chat room, if it gets bad, let me know and I'll restart the computer real quick. But maybe we can just push through it and make it work. Anyway, like I was saying, these guests are here tonight because of you guys. Because of Norova, who ran a charity event for, oh shit, Half-Life? Extra Life? What's it called? What was the charity?
Extra Life.
Extra Life for children. And you know what? They raised over $15,000. And the goal was to raise, I don't know what the goal was, but I know one of the goals was $10,000. And if they hit that, our good pals of the stream here, Chest and Cucumbers, were going to come and join us. And they're both here. Actually, it wasn't Cucumbers too, but he's here now. He's here to protect the innocent. And so, I guess say hello. Chest, hello. Say hi. No, you know what? Fine, Cucumbers, you were quick and easy like a Band-Aid. I like that. Chest, say hello to these people. They've waited so long to hear your sweet, sweet voice.
I don't want to be here.
Oh, but we're so thankful that you came on. You will trying to think. It's like a new pair of shoes. You just gotta walk around in them for a while.
Apparently your stream's going full restart.
You should probably switch to a static image.
As
per Norova.
Well, tell them to wait like 30 seconds, because I know there's a delay, and it looks like frames stop dropping. So if it doesn't continue to drop, then I'm going to leave it alone. And if it goes stupid again, then we'll give it the old restart. I'm really hoping not to have to restart it. But if we do, it's better to do it like in the first 10 minutes and then hopefully it's not a thing. So let's get right down into it, I guess. I already started talking about the charity. We thank Norova. He did an amazing job for the Extra Life charity and all those kids. And I feel like that's it. You guys have anything to say about the Extra Life thing?
Nah, go ahead. So sweet.
I mean, it worked out. I guess money for kids is cool.
Money for kids is stuck here. Even if you got stuck here. Oh, man. Just be glad you didn't offer to do anything else.
See, it's Cucumber's fucking fault, because we did some back-of-the-envelope math. And obviously, I don't want to be a jackass and be like, okay, let's okay, if you can break $1 million, Chess will come on the stream, which is entirely disingenuous.
Right.
So, Cukes, what is a good number that we can reach that, you know, might be just out of reach? He's like, 10 grand. There's no way you're going to do this based on this many people, this much money. And, of course, I wake up at 11 in the morning, like 5 hours in, it's already at fucking 7K.
Oh, that had to feel good.
I just knew I was fucked.
You were indeed fucked. Oh man, this is gonna be a messy stream. I can tell you right now, it's gonna be bad. All right, well, that's that. Let's get into the business, I guess. Chest, when did you start playing EverQuest?
I was on starting around, I guess, close to 1999. When did Valenzek come out? Because I was in Valenzek like the first week.
Oh man.
Played Valenzek until Sullenzek opened, and then was on Sullenzek till just after Planes of Powers.
You were on my server.
Well, I know who you are. We've already had this conversation before. I had real life friends that were in Defiant. I had real life friends that were in Ascending Dawn on Ralozek. Real life friends that were in Ruin and Hate on Sullenzek.
Did you have a real life friend that played a dwarf named Dagmar in Defiant?
Nope. My real life friends were the original Faldera. Uh-huh. He actually sold the account to one of our other real life friends, who was actually Firechild, who was a wizard in Defiant. And my other real life friend was in 12 Prophets, Cherry. He was an enchanter. And he eventually got banned for a bad surname. Because apparently can't be Cherry Popper on Live EQ. They'll fucking punch you.
That's an unacceptable name. That is unacceptable. Uh-oh. Stream might be down, guys. Alright. Here's what we're gonna do. Give me, like, 3 minutes. I'm gonna reset everything. And I'll call you guys right back. So, I'm not clicking buttons, I'm not doing anything, the stream died, there's a train driving past my window, and my window's open, because why wouldn't it be when there's a train going by? We're going to try this again. We've made some changes, we've done some things, hopefully it works better now. If it doesn't, just so you guys know, we're going to do it with or without you. We are going to record it offline if we have to, but this is happening. One way or the other. So, with that said, take two. I have Chest, I have Cukumbers. I'm very excited for both of them to be here, because I, in a million years, if you had asked me 2 weeks ago, I would have never thought that they would be here with me this evening. So, Cukumbers, say hello.
Hail.
Hail indeed, sir. Hail indeed. And Chest, say hello.
Yeah.
Good. Good. Neither of you said the word I asked for. Good job. So, we were, before we were so rudely interrupted, we were talking a little bit about Valenzek, and I don't remember exactly what we were talking about, because I just yelled at a very nice woman named Chris from Comcast. But, I did remember wanting to ask you, did you play on Red 99, and if not, why, with your PvP background?
Because the community from Red 99 is awful. Not to mention, all the names that I wanted were taken, including Chest. So why would I play on a server where I can't even have my own fucking name?
That is understandable. And how long have you been on Ye Olde Blue server?
Chest was created January 2011. I joined BDA April 2011, and I have not left yet. So, almost 4 years now, something like that.
Oh, man. You've been... Oh, buddy.
Right before Kunark.
You deserve some kind of medal.
Back when monks were easier to level, when you could zone and mend, and zone and mend, and zone and mend. It's fantastic.
Oh, you mean when you could do dirtiness?
Yeah, I leveled really fast. Thanks, buddy.
That's okay. Back in the day, you know, I know Nobog would break all my fingers off for saying this, but back in the day when you could do things like mend, and when you could just flop and get up and it was fine, and when we had spell sets. I miss all that shit. I don't care about maps or target rings.
The better one was bind wound while you're kiting, because you could stop and bind wound and just sit and stand up, which would stand you up, and you continue running, and bind wound would still fire like normal. So you could just run in circles and bind wound up if you're really being chased by something.
Oh, Jesus. Well, I'm sure Novog's very pleased that you can't do that anymore.
Well, I mean, he fixed all the other exploits I used to use on Solon's Egg. Like, I'd never leveled up legit when I played on Solon's Egg, ever in my entire life. Kinos, Aridin, the Hole had a bunch of exploits, so did Mistmoor, so did Akanon. Almost every zone in the game had some pathing bug, which are apparently all fixed on P99, not that I've ever checked them.
Oh, I'm not even going to lie. The first thing I did as a player was check all the bugs I knew about. And I was surprised. I was very surprised that a lot of them did not work. Some of them still do, though. Like, you can I shouldn't talk about it. But there's absolutely people that have been caught and disciplined for exploiting mob pathing. But like you, that's how I leveled on Valenzek, too. On a PvP server, you want to find out-of-the-way areas, and if you can go to a city and exploit bards in South Quainos, for example, A+.
Well, it was basically any mob on the wall in Quainos. You'd get up on the roof, and then there was all kinds of different places to pick off.
Oh, the bards were wonderful. They were so red that I would blow through my entire bar of mana and, like, sit down, med to full, and then blow through it again to kill them.
And see, Aridin was the best because they broke it twice. There was once where, like, you know, there's the teleporters that take you to the top and bottom when you're zoning up the Tox. That was the first exploit. So you'd be at the top and you'd warp down to the bottom and the mob would go, "Hey, where'd you go?" And it would stand there like an idiot. And you'd blow it up. Well, then they fixed that. So then you just basically had to find somewhere on the wall somewhere where they wouldn't path to you, and then you'd blow them up like that.
I would never do that. I played an Erudite on live. Iridin was like the one city I could bank in besides Feronovai, and I could bank in Halas if I hugged the right wall. And that might be it. And Thergadin when Velius came out.
I wasn't on Valenzek too much whenever Velius dropped. I mean, I think right after that is when Solenzek opened, and I made the jump immediately.
Oh, you dirty, dirty Solenzeker. How can you say bad things about the red community coming from Sullen Zek?
Because I grew the fuck up, man. I'm 30 years old. So I stopped being a degenerate, and now I'm trying to fucking be on the straight and narrow.
You hear that, red server? Chess says grow the fuck up. I'm going to paraphrase you all night long. I hope you're ready for that. So, I know you didn't start BDA, but, can you give me a little bit of how it started?
Somebody will probably correct me on this. I think they started on Kazakhul back on live, and they moved across numerous different emulator servers at some point. When I joined, it was being led by Sandlwin and Mirad. Sandlwin, who still plays Mirad, not so much. And then eventually leadership got passed from Sandlwin to Sadat and myself. And Sadat and I are co-leader with me holding the tag at the moment.
I like it. Although, you know what? I just made a huge mistake. I wanted to mute something that I was doing, and I muted you guys, but I didn't mute myself from stream, so they all heard it, but you guys didn't. It was very backwards and wrong. And what kind of people, if I'm a player who isn't in a guild and I just happen to be like, why is there 97 people on some fucking gay-ass EQ stream? And I'm wondering, because I don't play here, so I'm wondering these things. Tell me what kind of players is BDA looking for? How do I know if BDA is the guild for me?
If you prioritize real life before EQ, there's a good chance BDA is for you.
What if I've already sold my children into slavery and I whore out my wife or girlfriend for weekend money, drinking money.
Then you'll probably have a really good time in IB or TMO.
Shots fired. A plus. All right. So how do you feel about the class system? How do you feel that's going now that we're in month nine or ten of the class R, class C system?
I think it works fine as long as you stop fucking shit up.
Could you be more specific? I fuck a lot of shit up. It's hard for me to know what you're talking about when you are vague.
So there are numerous instances of punishments levied on Class R guilds of a very stressful and... not stressful, that's not the word I'm looking for. A very serious punishment versus the hand slaps in Class C, which gets really old to deal with. Like, let's look at Sev, which was what? Saturday? Was that Sunday or Saturday that happened?
I don't know. I was out of town until Saturday. I didn't anything Sunday.
Oh, well, who popped up on Sirkin the second that it went down then?
If I was there, then it couldn't have been Saturday.
I don't remember what day it was. It was either Saturday or Sunday. I don't remember. Either way,
well, what happened? What was the situation?
I believe the situation from my sources, as discussed with the rest of Class R, was that TMO had a tracker on the spawn point, and it got illegal FTE, and there was some bullshit that happened. Eventually, the mob got trained to the TT zone line, and Taken won the FTE lottery after that and killed the mob. And then I believe TMO petitioned, because I know Taken didn't petition, even though TMO says, oh, we never petition without discussing with other guild leaders first. Right? Yeah? Is that true?
I suppose that's true, sure.
And then suddenly you appeared like a goddamn genie.
Did I do anything?
I don't know. Nothing yet. You'd figure that if TMO had been already told once never to have a tracker on the spawn point, and then Catherine tried to petition it, and y'all did nothing again, and then they actually got in trouble for the exact thing that you told them not to do, you'd think there'd be some sort of punishment, right?
You'd think there would be. Does anyone in chat know exactly what day this was? And I'll also say, because I was out of town most of last week, I know there's a slight backup of petitions waiting for me, because no petitions have gotten done.
And you were right there. I figured that you could just rule on something as you popped up like a genie.
Are you sure I popped up like a genie?
Yes, motherfucker, I saw you there.
See?
Everyone saw you there.
You're talking about your sources. It makes it sound like you weren't there with your own eyes.
Cukes, confirm.
Fuck if I know. I wasn't there.
Cucumbers, that is not why you're here, sir. We need solid answers from you. You're the tiebreaker.
BDA in chat, speak up if you saw him there, because I definitely did. I zoned over from TT to EJ. Sirkin's sitting there like a derpy person, not saying anything.
Was I very reminiscent of someone who was AFK?
How do you be AFK when you pop into the zone after you get petitioned? How does that work?
I don't know. I'm looking up encounter logs right now. I'm logging in to verify the legitimacy of the request.
You were there.
Oh, man. I was there for a lot of things. I will say, if there's a petition, I haven't looked at it. And if it was from this weekend, I absolutely... What's today? Third is Monday... The first was Saturday. Oh shit. I might have been there.
Oh, big shocker.
Well, you could have said it was Saturday night.
Motherfucker, I don't know.
Well, I thought you were there. I thought you saw me with your own eyes.
Shit bleeds together. I don't remember exactly what fucking day it was. I knew you were there at the encounter. Figure it out. You got logs? I don't.
I did. I figured it out. It was November 1st, Saturday night. 1944.
God damn.
And 11 seconds. Well, shit. I can't, I'm not even gonna look in... You know what? I'll look. I'm gonna look in the petition form. Let's see if there's anything about Seb with my name on it. Well, let's go to advanced search. We're advanced peoples here. Search titles. Motherfucking circuits. We do not want that. Did you guys petition it, or you don't know if anyone did for sure?
I mean, I don't know if anyone petitioned because Taken got the loot, so I don't know if IB was pissed. I don't know if TMO was pissed. I'm pretty sure TMO is the one that petitioned somebody. Don't know where it came from after that.
Okay. I have no petitions regarding said from this weekend.
Well, how about this? Let's go ahead and discuss this publicly then. What did you tell everybody in your post on the raid forums?
I tell people a lot of shit. It usually says, don't do X, Y, and Z, or I will ban everybody forever.
Okay, so here's what X, Y, and Z was in this discussion. You said you're not allowed to have mages or whoever your FTE person is on the spawn point. That was your rule that you made. So then, a couple weeks later, Catherine went and tried to petition TMO because they had people on the spawn point. And the ruling was that, well, you know, nothing actually happened. So until it actually happens and they're actually in the wrong, then there's no such thing as any sort of rule breaking that's going on.
Right. That sounds like something I would say.
Right. Catherine, doing her due diligence, was trying to keep them from being, you know, in the wrong and causing loot to get deleted. Which, you know, if I was in Taken's position and I was sitting there waiting for a dragon, I wouldn't want some FTE illegal bullshit going down and loot getting deleted, because that still takes loot out of, you know, that I could potentially get.
Right. It's taking food off your plate.
Sure. So now we're in the situation where what she petitioned didn't get resolved, or got resolved. It just got ruled, you know, no foul. And then, I believe the TMO tracker got FTE on Sev, the mage. Oops, my bad.
Okay, well, here's what I would say to do. It sounds like I gave some shitty answer because I just got home and didn't feel like dealing with anything, but I wanted to at least be there. As far as the TMO thing, they shouldn't be on the spawn spot, period, for any reason. And that's not just them, that's for everybody. We don't want trackers on spawn spots. I don't know, like, how we can make that any more clear than we've made that in the past.
Hold on.
If anyone from Taken or your guild or any other guild has anything of the dragon popping with them on the spawn spot, make a forum petition. Send it in.
There's an easy way to fix this problem. And so I can just jump on my next platform, which is...
Jump.
You need to get rid of the stupid FFA cycle. It needs to be CR, FFA on repops. Then you basically put a fucking nail into the heart that is poopsocking, because it won't happen.
If we get rid of FFA, it's going to go CCR. We're just going to give that 2C.
See, why would you do that? That doesn't make any sense.
FFA was created with, in the mind of the staff, assuming that probably 90%, if not more, at least 90% of FFA would go to Class C. And the staff never intended to take mobs away from Class C. That's something they never understood. They were never losing anything, because the free-for-all, like every third, would be a free-for-all, which would generally go to the Class C guilds. And then there would also be earthquakes to add extra mobs to the game. So the IBs and the TMOs and at the time the forceful entries of the world, none of them were actually losing mobs. They were still going to get the same amount, maybe a little tiny bit less, but not worth getting all worked up over. What else?
Do you realize what the current split is right now, what that kind of stuff is, as far as mobs for Class E versus mobs for Class R, or does it matter?
Well, right now it's just a third. C gets a third, R gets a third, and then a third is free-for-all.
Well, I mean, if you factor in, okay, you know, third, a third, a third as far as opportunities, but do you know what the current pull-down is for this is how much Class C is getting, this is how much Class R is getting?
I know that Class R is averaging half of a Trachanon a month per guild.
So, I did some back-of-the-envelope math on this, and I'm trying to find my post because it's long as stupid. I don't know where the fuck I put it.
Oh, I did some math on this too, actually. I've been sending it to some guild leaders recently.
Where is it? And I can't find this shit.
Well, while you're looking, I can give you some math that's probably going to be exactly what you're going to say. If you pull Trachodon, for example, which is a 3-day spawn on average, you're looking at 10 to 12, and assuming there's, you know, a couple earthquakes, you're looking at 10 to 12 Trachodons a month. Figure only 4 of those would be Class R, because they're only getting a third. With 8 guilds, I believe it's 8 guilds rotating Trachodon at the moment on R, that's one Trachodon every 60 days, and I believe with the 7-day spawns, you're looking at every 90 days. And those wait times are only going to get longer and longer and longer as more guilds come to the server or form up or whatever, whatever, and join and start raiding and start playing with you guys and all those things. And when there's twice as many guilds, you'll be looking at 180 days wait time. And that's kind of insane. And what I will say to that is Class R was never intended to be a retirement home for anybody. Class R was intended to be a jumping off point to get guilds ready to join Class C. We never built the system with guilds purposely just staying in R in mind. And
except
we're not the ones that put the rotation into place. That was you guys.
Right, but because we want to play with a little bit more civility, we should be punished for that.
No. But you can't blame the staff for the 90-day wait periods on a rotation when we had nothing to do with the rotation.
I'm not concerned about the 90-day wait period. I'll wait my fucking place in line if I have to. I'm concerned about the fact that the FFA portion of the game is a shit show. You can say that, okay, yeah, let's compete harder for mobs. It's not competing harder for mobs. It's people sitting there looking at a screen waiting 16 hours. And cough ducking, which has now turned into foot races for the time being because Taken decided they didn't want to cough duck anymore. The current proportion of mobs, if you break it down like this, okay, so if you're doing just an average number of mobs per month and you're looking at 4 repops a month, it's broke 3 parts, you know, you have your C, R, FFA. It's about 40 per area. Except that, you know, Class C gets 90% of those FFA mobs, and then they get every single mob in VP. That's their private playground.
Right.
So currently the way it's structured, and you know, on an average number of months, number of spawns, whatever, did the math. Class C is splitting 120 something potential kills.
Mm-hmm.
That's what they're fighting over, 120 different kills.
I'm just blindly trusting your math on this.
Oh, I mean, I can show you the way I did it.
I don't want to see it. I'm just trusting you.
Alright. Class R is splitting something like 40 something kills. So we got 10 guilds, because there are 10 guilds in Class R right now, divvying up 40-something mobs. We got Class C fighting over 100-something mobs. If we did it where we went C, R, and met FFA full repop, kept the bag limit, kept Class C as the VP playground, it would go for 100 mobs for Class C to about 60-something in Class R.
Yeah. Why? But see, here's the thing, though. If we keep giving more stuff to Class R, that doesn't give anyone incentive to leave Class R.
They're not going to leave Class R because the playstyle's bullshit. Nobody wants to sit there and deal with the bullshit that is TMO and IB. They're entitled to play the game however the hell they want. You know, you provided rules to let them play that game in that manner. And that's fine. You know, they're entitled to that as well. But what about the vast majority of this server that does not want to play in that manner? That's the issue. There's 10 guilds that are on this server right now that are part of the Class R rotation. There's at least 2 more that are up and coming that should probably be on the rotation soon. I know Anonymous contacted me the other day. They're a guild that's coming. I know Forceful Entry wants to come back, and we're going to fucking not let that happen because it's bullshit. That Shinko, a TMO fucking veteran, wants to go lead a Class R guild. That's bullshit that you'd even allow that, but that's a whole other point. I'll get to that fucking shit in a second.
Right, we'll get to the FE thing in a minute. Let's keep on the RC FFA for now.
If they want actual competition, FFA repops is the only way to do it. If you have, it's just an FFA mob getting doled out every couple hours, people will sit there for 16 hours at a time waiting for those mobs, socking, which is what they're doing. If you want healthy, actual competition, let's see, fight over 100-something mobs. That's what they're doing. They get all of VP, and they'll have another giant chunk of mobs. They can fight over all that shit however the hell they want. Tear each other's heads up. I don't care. But then you have another 60-something mobs that will go to Class R. And anything that's in an FFA, everybody can just, you know, show up and race for it. Like, it should be done, as opposed to sitting there with socks for 16 hours at a time, which is absurd. If you wanted R to be a jump-off point to eventually go to C, an FFA was supposed to be some sort of training ground to get to C. It's failed miserably. And you know what? We had this conversation, not in front of the public, obviously, when that whole genocidal tendency shit went down, mm-hmm. where we both agreed. And, like, we had this conversation. You may not remember. We both agreed that
FFA scene has failed. It was our first good conversation.
Yeah, the FFA scene has failed horribly if it's supposed to be the bridge between R and C. And it's not doing what it's supposed to do. So why does it exist if it's not functioning in the capacity that it's supposed to function in the first place?
Okay, again, FFA is not supposed to be a jump. Class R as itself is a jumping off point. It gives guilds access to raid content that was completely monopolized by TMO and IB at the time.
Right.
And so that... Now that this content has been opened up to them and they can gear their characters, they can prepare themselves to actually make attempts at VP should they want to go to Class C. Or, if you want to go to Class C and not deal with the TMO and the IBs of the world, you can live off earthquakes outside of VP and still get more mobs than you would get waiting in rotation on Class R.
It's not about wait time. I don't understand why you keep hammering that point. But here's if it was about wait time, hold on.
If you're out of VP, you're not dealing with their play style because you're not playing against them. They start in VP. You start a tracking on, you go to VS.
But there's no guarantee that the mobs you want are going to be Class C.
That's true. But even if only one of the three monthly repops or earthquakes happens to be Class C, that's still one mob a month, and that's better than half a mob a month, which is what you're getting with a 60-day wait period on Trachanon.
Again, wait time is not the issue. If it was an issue, we'd have guilds that would have moved to Class C already. It's not. We have a different play style we want to play to.
How is play style an issue when you're not when they're in VP and you're not in VP? You're not going against them.
Because there's no guarantee you're still going to get it. Like, right now, TMO actually laughed at the fact that there was two extra mobs up in VP, and they bailed to go chase a different mob. If VP is such a high-priority content, and they need so much stuff from there, why would they leave two dragons up to go after CT?
Maybe they were the two shitty... There's two shitty VP dragons that are not even close to the best loot in the game. I don't know VP well enough, but they're the two that TMO and IB offered up to Class R at one point during the negotiations back in January and early February.
Look, what I'm saying is if you want VP to be the be-all, end-all, and that's what we should be shooting for, then why would they leave mobs up in VP? They can go, okay, those are the shitty ones. Those don't count.
Nexona and Silverwing, those are the two.
Right, so that's convenient for them now. Whenever the argument prior to that was VP is the be-all, end-all, and everyone should go to VP. But now the argument all of a sudden when it's convenient is, oh, well, those mobs don't actually count. They're not that good.
Faradar, Drushk, and who am I forgetting? All right, and the other ones? They drop some of the best shit in the absolute game. It's two of the six that don't. And that's only because of mobs like Kha'Zix Thul, and the breastplates from Trachanon, and whatever, maybe some stupid epic pieces if you have a new alt or a new member that needs them. That's part. They don't leave VP until those first four dragons are dead. Like I said, I mean, if it's playstyle, you can completely avoid the mixing and mashing by just staying out of VP when they're in VP. And you would only get the repop mobs, but waiting isn't apparently an issue. So the lack of content wouldn't really be a lack of content. They would be the same
again,
more, actually.
Again, it's not the lack of content. Again, what I'm trying to say before is the FFA tier of the raid cycle is irreparable. It does not function as it was intended to from the start.
Well,
it's not really competition. It's sitting there for 16 hours waiting for a mob to spawn. And that's obviously not what anyone intended for that to be. There's no skill involved with how fast you can mash Koth, or if you zone faster than the other bard, run to the mob faster. There's no skill involved.
If it was up to me, mages wouldn't be tracking or coughing anybody. When I threw that up there, everybody threw a temper tantrum, and I decided to take it down because I couldn't deal with the whining and the tears that came from that. I think the call of the heroes to the cough tracking crap, I think that's crap. I think if it was up to me, I wouldn't allow it anywhere, not even for tracking on.
No, there's additional strategies. There's always going to be something new that comes up. So cough ducking was the first thing that came up whenever the new raid rules are implemented. There's always somebody pushing the envelope every single time. So just because that was the strategy that was figured out, doesn't mean there's not going to be a new strategy figured out after that and when it gets changed to foot races or whatever the next stupid rule set that we implement. The bottom line that I'm trying to get to is that the vast majority of the server, not just the people in Class R, I'm talking about all the casual players that also play this game.
Everyone who's not Class C is Class R by default.
I'm talking about whoever's in the rotation right now versus whoever's not in the rotation and still coming up. Mm-hmm. The vast majority of the people on the server that want to see the end game don't want to play the game in the manner that the way TMO and IB do. And again, it's fine to differentiate between those two play styles, mm-hmm. but there needs to be a better way for those people to come up through Class R and get to Class C if that's what the end game is supposed to be. And right now there's not. It's because the FFA scene is broken. It's supposed to be that bridge. It doesn't function that way.
It's supposed to be a place for you to test your mettle against Class C guild, sure. But it's also intended that most of that goes to Class C. We knew when we put the system in place that probably 90% of FFA mobs would go to Class C guilds. That's, like, we did that knowing that would happen. Now that that's a thing, we don't look at it and see it as broken. We see that as exactly what we thought was going to happen when we put it in place. I mean, you might not like it, you might think that's stupid as shit, but when it was put in place, we knew Class C would take 90% of the FFA mobs.
Yeah, and if they were outskilling people to get the mobs, then I'd understand that, but they're not. They're outstalking people, and that's absurd.
You should see some of the stuff going on in VP, you'd be impressed.
Right, and again, VP doesn't count because I'm not looking at that. I understand all the shenanigans involved with VP. Let's train this away to go engage that and run this person here, whatever. Have fun doing that. But I'm talking about the sevs of the world, where you have four guilds sitting there staring at a screen waiting for a mob to spawn and then somehow racing. There's no skill involved with that. There's skill involved in VP, sure, I'll give you that, because it's a shit show of a zone. I hate that place. That's one of the worst zones in the goddamn world. Can't gate anywhere. Everything season viz, shit hits way too hard, too many A's, hate it.
Yeah, I mean, I played on Valenzek. You played on Valenzek. You know what it was like. I enjoy racing for mobs. I know there's not PvP on the blue server, obviously, but I don't see why people can't race for mobs. If it was up to me, like I said before, I'd get rid of the cough tracking. As far as, like, I'm not going to shit on Class R, but you guys aren't angels. I mean, you guys, some of you bring 50 to 70 people to raids. Some of you guys poop sock. Some of you guys track all day long. You guys definitely are involved with the call of the hero ducking bullshit. I mean, you guys have been doing all kinds of things yourselves as well. It's not like you are these perfect, pristine angels.
I think you're over-exaggerating, because there's only one guild that was caught ducking. No other guild wanted to participate in that with Class R. It was just taken. And they were doing it mostly just to annoy TMO and IB, because, you know, it forced them into a playstyle they didn't want to be in either. When, you know, what was the beginning of it when there was no cough trackers? It was the whole FTE javelin shit. If you walked up to TMO or IB whenever a mob spawned, or right before a mob spawned, it's like, hey guys, let's not jab spam. They just laugh at you. So TMO and IB telling Taken, hey guys, let's not cough duck, you know, is laughable considering the treatment they were given initially.
Real quick, just to address Yuckers, players aren't allowed to have characters camped out at mob spawn points, and if they do, petition them and we'll suspend them. We've done it in the past, and it hasn't been an issue for a while now. But if it is an issue again, start petitioning it again, and we'll start suspending people for it again, because that's absolutely a rule, and people should not be camping out alts or whatever at spawn points. Except, you know, the two tracker thing.
Is it time for cucumbers to say something? I feel like I...
Cucumbers, you can jump in at any moment, by the way. Any moment.
I have totally not been listening to what you guys have been saying.
That's good. That is good. Way to earn your keep around here.
Sorry.
So, let's go to a new topic, since this is obviously a non-starter. Why did you allow Shinko to recreate Forceful Entry and want them to go chase mobs in Class R?
When he
participates in a Class C guild as a Class C member.
Funny story there. Shinko was trying to get the Forceful Entry guild tag from me, and I refused to give it to him multiple times. And when I was in California last week, I came back to find out supposedly Umbrella had given him the tag, and he was going to try to make it a Class R guild. I've received private messages from multiple guild leaders, and I have copy and pasted the same exact reply to said guild leaders and Daribel and Rogan every single time it's gone out. I'm not going to read it because it's an entire wall of text, but if you want, I will PM it to you so you can read it at your leisure. Basically, you guys don't get to decide who's in Class R and who's not. Anyone who's not in C is in R. That being said, if anybody's going to try to create a guild to put in Class R to funnel loot or pixels or any kind of advantage for Class C, that's unacceptable. That goes against absolutely everything we are doing. And while we very rarely punish entire guilds, it has happened. And I don't mean like guild suspensions or raid suspensions. I mean banning the leaders, probably banning or suspending the officers, disbanding the guild and putting it on the pretty list of guild names that are no longer acceptable on this server. If they want to go that route, I can play that game with them. We're going to keep very close eyes on them, and we're going to monitor what they do. If they're a legit Class R guild, then we'll let them be a legit Class R guild. If it's just a bunch of C alts that are trying to get pixels for their alts that don't have to come out of Class C, like I said, that's not okay. That's not something that we're going to let fly. And that's something we're definitely going to bring the hammer down on pretty quickly and pretty hard.
I mean, and that's actually really interesting, because that's a complete 180 from what Daribel told some of the other people that petitioned as well. Where Daribel basically said, you know, we can't control who goes in Class R, and I don't have the time or inclination to go check to make sure all of these people that are coming through with Forceful Entry are actually Class C alts, or they're just straight up-and-coming noobs.
Okay, I know what Daribel was referring to, and what he was referring to is slightly different. What he's referring to is when people go to him and say, I want to know what people in my guild are Class C alts, or what people in my guild are TMO spies. We're not going to go through guild rosters of close to 1,000 people and try to match login accounts with each name to see if any of them have ever shared a login with a TMO member. That's an insane waste of our time. And, I mean, you guys are not BDA, but guild leaders as a whole are responsible for who they invite into their guild, and they're responsible for the screening process. If you guys invite people who happen to be spies or alts, that's your problem. That's not on us. That's what Daribel is referring to when he gives that answer, because I've seen him give that exact answer to people in the past.
And I always thought that was wonderful.
So I plan on going to Mischief. Mischief would be good.
Well, that's A+. Let me see. Let me check my list. I wanted to talk about Bloomin' Opinions, but I feel like that's more of a... we just can't have as much fun with that as I can have with Daribel, because he's the RMT guy. Oh, and Yeah, oh, you already asked me about that, but I'll tell you again. If there's people waiting to be unbanned, just have them, you know, check their petition. I don't think bumping helps, but maybe, I don't know. I don't think it does. I'm pretty sure Darabail starts with the oldest petitions first and then works his way to the newest ones. And yeah, I know it's a shitty thing, but it really is just how we do things, and it's a safety thing because we don't know who's who. All we see are the account IDs, and we don't know where shit is stashed, and we don't know what is an RMTer's alt and what is just an innocent person who got caught up in the net. And so we go through each account, and after it is cleared, or we look at it and be like, oh, this is clearly not an RMTer because this is chest, then we unban the account. It's what
I think it would have been easier to do it by a timeline.
No.
Like, okay, so the accounts that got popped for the BDA side, they hadn't been logged on by a culprit in like 2 years. Like, how are those possibly associated with RMT at this point?
Because they're associated with culprit. There's no timeline thing because we don't, like, say we catch a guy RMTing, okay? We have no idea how long he's been RMTing. We have no idea how many accounts he's been using to RMT. We have no idea how many computers or IP addresses he has at his disposal. We have no idea. And so we throw a net on everything, literally everything he has ever touched, so that we can individually clear each account to make sure we get all of the dirty money and all of the dirty items and that we shut him down as hard as we can.
Yeah, except if those accounts hadn't been logged in for, like, he hasn't had access to them for 2 years.
Right.
Well, if you don't have logs of that, then yeah, that's one thing. But it seems silly that, oh, he hasn't touched it in 2 years. He hasn't had any sort of account or any sort of contact with it. Like, how could he possibly RMT it from an account he can't have access to, that he hasn't had access to in 2 years? Silly. I get the policy. It's just silly. There's got to be a cleaner way to do it.
I agree. I absolutely agree. Things are not perfect. Absolutely not. But right now, based on the tools we have, it's the safest way for us to do it without letting something slip through our fingers or slip through the cracks. And I know we catch up lots of innocent people when we do that shit. I know we do. Probably more innocent players get affected than guilty players, to be perfectly honest. But, like, your people, they're not going to stay banned. Like, I'm pretty sure of that, because...
Oh, yeah, they don't even play anymore, so it's not like it's an issue. It's just they were accounts that were touched at one point or another, which is why they no longer are functioning.
Yeah.
Anyways, I posted questions from the Peanut Gallery to us to try and get something of substance.
If there are questions in the chat that you want to answer...
No, they're all terrible. Let's see. Antheory says, can we go to bed? I'm assuming at some point we will.
Yeah, I didn't see anything worth pulling. That's why I didn't mention anything.
Will I be banned for buying pixels? Blah, blah, blah. Yes, you can't sting somebody. You're an idiot. Chest, why do you believe your guild should get free pixels? You're a moron. Going through this.
People are dumb as shit.
Do gingers have souls? Yes. Here's one that you could actually might answer. Wait, no. Chess, why do you cry so much? Nope. Not going to answer that one either. Can we get some serious questions? Probably not. Can we get an XP bonus sometime soon?
Maybe if something breaks.
Maybe if something breaks. All right, good answer.
Usually it's like an I'm sorry or a... Let us try to make up for that with XP bonus.
Why is the staff required to manage in-game content / guild relations from soulscry_?
Do we manage guild relations?
No, you're fucking terrible at it, so I don't know why that's even a relevant question.
I mean, if he means, like, maintaining relations between the staff and guilds, I think it's always good for communication to be there. Between staff and guild leaders, just so they feel comfortable coming to you with an issue, and so that you can feel comfortable going to them and being like, hey, this needs to stop, or hey, good job on that. As far as guild-to-guild relations, staff doesn't care.
Let's see. Here's another one. Did we come to an understanding that no trackers may be sitting on spawn points, factioned or otherwise?
Don't sit on spawn points. Just don't do it. That's a thing.
Well, I guess that doesn't count for Sev last Saturday.
Well, someone needs to petition that.
You were there!
I wasn't there when he popped. I was there before he popped, and I told somebody I wasn't going to play Time Cop, I believe.
Jesus Christ. let's see. Darable said people should be nice to me. Whatever. Actually, these questions suck. Shut up, Nyx. I will go ahead and... think that's a good idea. Thanks, Jarn. Man, Jarn does not like Nyx.
No, either does Norova.
Lots of people yelling at Nyx. I mean, I don't like Nyx either, but I'm not going to give her the attention. Blah, 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 blah. All these questions are fucking terrible. Why do you even run this stream? No one even asks good questions. Like, what's the point if they don't ask good questions?
Here's the thing, and chat room is going to hate this. I don't pay any attention to the chat room when I stream on Monday nights. I literally, if I'm in-game, I'll pay attention to in-game. And if I'm running a video, I'm usually doing something else in the other monitor and just shooting the shit with the people in stream. And that's a thing. So, yeah. I concur. Uber Bandit is a regular guest here on my stream, and he handles chat. I don't even look at it. He'll pull the good questions when they come and be like, oh, here's a question from such and such so-and-so, bloody 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 blue. And I'll be like, here's your answer. But other than that...
Is Cukes even still there? Does he exist still?
I'm here.
He's here. He's just... He's like...
How do you feel about not being an officer anymore since you can kick back and live the good life and just enjoy EverQuest again?
There's so much room for activities.
He's like, I can do things.
Yeah, it's great.
Nice.
I log in and nobody sends me a tell. And if they do, it's like scary and he calls me a derogative. It's awesome.
Oh man, I'm going to start
living the life.
I'm going to start sending you officer related tells.
Yeah, they try to get, like, when it's a guild thing, we have to, like, we need a representative for BDA. All the TMO guys want Cucumbers to show up because he actually tolerates their bullshit, and I have a short fuse.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to broadcast that it's his birthday during prime time and have 1,000 people send him a tell. That's what I'm going to do.
You already missed his birthday.
It doesn't have to actually be his birthday. I don't give any shits about his birthday. I want to spam him with 1,000 tells.
He tried to hide it. Like he erased his birthday from the BDA forums. So nobody knew. But we found out, I think, through Facebook. I can't remember how we figured it out.
Yeah, you creepy bastards.
They stalked you. It's all right. That's what you get for being on Facebook. You shouldn't be on Facebook.
I mean, I didn't want to be on Facebook, but that's part of being in a relationship. My girlfriend has to be able to say, this is a person that exists.
Oh, my last girlfriend was not on Facebook, and I really, truly believed she was the only other person not on it, and I thought she was wonderful. And now that we're not together, I think I'm even happier that neither one of us are on Facebook.
Yeah, I was stupidly made a comment about my girlfriend playing on Red the other night, and... somebody found out who she was based on, like, where she died and got yellow texted. Because there's only two people in that zone when it happened. And so, I can't remember if it was just people wanted to go find her and kill her, or they wanted to say, hey, join Holocaust and we'll give you loot. I'm not sure.
Maybe both.
I'm sure she would take loot if they gave it to her.
Well, anyone should take loot. That's a thing.
I mean, I might consider playing on Red if I could get a cool name, but everything that I want's taken. Like, where the fuck is my own name? Why can't I be my own name?
Got my own name.
Sure, it's something fantastic. There's no way it's Anthrax.
That's awesome. Fuck yes.
I just blew him up in Vin. I'm like, you asshole. Can I get the name Django? Because I can make an erudite SK and then I'll be happy and I'll play. The D's silent. Sounds like you should give me the name. I mean, I have my Erudite SK on blue, but I went with Silky Johnson.
Silky, silky, smooth Johnson.
He's a player hate of the year.
I got my character on Red up to level 20, and then I became a GM and had to stop. I played as a guide. I didn't give any shits. But they told me I had to stop if I was going to be a GM. I was talking to another guide earlier today, the new one, Morgan, and he was all like, I'm gonna probably give my player account information to a few friends. If they strip me or RMT my account, can I get it back, or how does that work? And I'm like, you're fucked if they do that. Like, I haven't shared my account information with fucking anybody, and he's been collecting dust for 3 years now.
Look, the smartest way to save your gear if you don't want to get stripped is go die somewhere and let your shit rot.
Yep, 100% truth.
And then when you want your shit back, you petition to get it, and they pull it out of the aether or whatever it is corpses go whenever they rot, and then you have your stuff back.
That's where it goes.
And I learned that from Ambrotos.
Oh, Ambrotos did not like me at all.
Well, I like Ambrotos.
Well, you guys have that in common. I have been talking to people recently, and I have found out all kinds of things that he basically went around telling people that I was a shitty person. Unbelievable. He told people not to talk to me, told people I was a dirty RM... Oh, shit. Told people I was a dirty RMT-er. All kinds of horrible shit.
Well, I mean, I don't know if you're an RMT-er, but I'm not super fond of you either.
Oh, man.
But it's mostly because you make bad decisions.
Well, that's fine. That's fine. I can... You want to accuse me of making bad decisions? That's a thing that happens sometimes. You can accuse me of that. But accusing me of shit that people have been accusing me of for 3 years on this server and 2 years on another server, and never once has anybody had any proof of said accusations... It's hard for me to take them seriously. People get mad when I troll them in the forums when they accuse me of RMT, and I, like, oh, well, you sit there and you joke about blooming onions and you think it's a big joke. It's like, I do think it's a big joke, because at this point, like, I feel like I've put in enough time to where if you don't have proof, just shut up and go away. Like, I've seen the RMT thread so many times. I've supposedly RMT'd with TMO, I've RMT'd with IB, I've RMT'd with Inglourious Basterds. I'm literally RMT'ing with anybody who's killing mobs. And even though I flip-flop with who I RMT with, I never burn my bridges because nobody ever snitches or takes screenshots or records conversations or ever fucking has proof of anything. I get real mad about the RMT accusations because it's insulting
integrity. If you would be more consistent with your rulings, you wouldn't have that problem. But when you make,
that I'm a dummy. They shouldn't just assume I'm fucking getting paid off.
You can't make a hard and fast rule, and then absolutely refuse to enforce the rule. And when you enforce it against one person but not the other, then it looks like favoritism.
Fine, but that's bad decision making and being a dummy. That's insulting my integrity.
When it happens over and over again. Then it looks like it's favoritism, and then it insults your integrity.
Well, basically, the too long didn't read of what you just said is nerds are gonna nerd.
I don't know about that.
That's what you said. That's what I'm quoting. I'm deleting everything, and I'm gonna be like, Chess, we had technical difficulties. I need you to sum up the entire stream in 4 words. And it's just gonna be you saying, well, it's gonna be me saying nerds are gonna nerd, but I'm gonna pretend it's you saying it. And then I'm going to edit you to be like, I know about that.
God, and there's a bunch of motherfuckers trying to get me to go on every other fucking stream there was. Like, it took 10 grand and an act of God to get me on this stream. Ain't no fucking way I'm going on any other fucking streams, man.
Oh, praise God. What is Bum Fights of Norrath?
He gets people to fight on his stream, and you watch. Like people in the tunnel.
Oh, God damn it. So we have bum fights in the East Commons tunnel now, apparently, huh?
Like, yeah, you'll get rid of casinos, but you won't get rid of bum fights. Good job.
I didn't even know bum fights was an actual thing until this moment. And casinos were so dirty.
You're not doing your job. That's all I'm going to say.
I feel like bum fight police is not my department. I feel like that's not where I deal with things.
Anyways, fix the FFA scene. It's not hard.
Well, I guess, I mean, it depends. It depends on how we think it's broken.
Oh, I mean, I think we agree that it's not functioning the way it's supposed to function. Unless its functionality is supposed to be give 90% of the mobs to Class C off the top, which it shouldn't be.
That's pretty much what they were getting before everything.
That's silly. The raid scene needs to be fundamentally changed. The culture of raiding has to be changed. If you want to fix the culture of raiding, you have to fundamentally change the way it works. And if you make it CNR, split the mobs, and then on full repops, it's always FFA. Everybody has to race for everything. And there's no socking. And then the culture of the raid scene has changed. Simple. Clean. Efficient.
Oh, buddy. Maybe. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to send me math. Or actually, no, I don't even need your math. I'll pull encounter logs. I'll do my own math. But I'd need to see exactly what the numbers are going to be. The other problem with the repop free-for-alls, right now they're coming in good because Rogan's not as busy at work. Over the summer, the repops were very far and few between because he was very busy at work. If the only free-for-all mobs are the earthquake mobs, that's completely dependent on Rogan's schedule. There's no guarantee, as we saw over the summer, that we'll get 3 a month. And so
yeah, I get that, and that is potentially
they're going to be
not helpful.
It's not helpful, and the rest of the staff, I know, myself included, we're all going to be hesitant to be like, well, this will be free for all, but we can't guarantee you any type of set amount or tell you how many to expect.
Yeah, but if you keep the FFA cycle intact, then it just perpetuates the cycle of raiding that we've had for so long, for almost 5 years now, where it was sock the spawn point, and then it's sock the zone line, and then it's sit at your screen at the login, and now it's wait by zone line.
We told people to stop the poop socking.
Everybody, you can't make them stop it. Why? How, what makes you think you can tell them how to do something? Everybody bullshit, they didn't agree to anything.
Everybody agreed to it.
They agreed to not poop sock? When did they agree to that?
When we agreed to shorten the variance, it was based on everybody agreeing to stop the poop socking.
Yeah, they meant agree not to sit on the spawn point. Well, no one ever agreed to that.
That's people twisting words. They started outside the zone line. Oh, and they started
I'm shocked that hardcore raiders would abuse potentially your words to figure out a better way to do something. I'm utterly flabbergasted that they would twist your words up and find their own answers.
I almost fainted. I literally almost fainted. I couldn't believe it. I see our player base as the most highly bestest player base around. I would never expect
some actions. And you know what? The percentage of people that are doing that in two guilds is 15% of the server. Maybe 15%. You could probably pull up TMO and IB and then pull up number of like active characters that have logged on in the past, I don't know, year. And it's going to be between 10 and 15% are IB players and then everybody else. 10 or 15% of the server is currently getting almost 80% of the mobs.
Sounds classic to me.
It doesn't sound classic whenever we've been in the same expansion for how long? Oh, like there's like
3 years, 3.5 years?
Right, and that's not y'all's fault because I'm sure you're devving the fuck out of getting Velius up.
I'm not a dev. I can't speak for them, but from what I know, they are working so diligently on it.
Yeah, and everyone is very, very happy with that. I mean, the other very, very radical solution that I talked about that I don't know if people saw it or not, but I know it got a lot of traction when we were talking about it amongst the Class R guilds, was split the blue servers.
There's an awful idea, and you should feel bad about it.
No, you're wrong. You actually like it. Splitting the blue servers is an awful idea?
Yeah, I like my friends. Stop making me pick my friends.
No. So you have one server where you can be a hardcore degenerate if you want to be. Leave that server the way it is. And you do a move log for a new blue server. And you say, okay, this blue server will be run in like a rotation in the image of the current Class R rotation.
I don't know. Splitting the population just seems like a bad idea.
It's not going to split the population. It's going to leave basically TMO and IB behind. And everybody else is going to go sit there and rotate mobs because it's... And that's another way to classically play the game. Like, classic sometimes was, cutthroat, bloodthirsty competition. And sometimes it was Guild Council of Karana deciding on who gets loot and how you divvy it out.
Well, like I said before, write up something and have the guild leaders that agree with that sign it, send it off to Rogan, and I will make sure he takes a look at it.
Yeah, and do you know how fast, like, you thought 15K in a day was fun? You know how fast you would fund? You, like, Roji could say, it's 30K for me to start this off the ground for a new blue server with MoveLog. You'd get that in a day and a half, max.
Oh, Jesus, that's insane.
Yeah.
Well.
Like, that's what I don't understand, is I get that, you know, the Class C is currently who's being catered to. But the vast majority of the people in this game, the vast majority of the people on this server don't want a raid like that. And they will gladly wait in line or give them their own server. Fuck, I mean, how hard is it to take the entire server and copy it and then do a move log? That's just work for y'all to do to implement the move log portion. But the rest of it is just, okay, how much is it going to cost to host? What hardware do we need for it? Blah, blah, blah. And it would raise as much money as Roji could set the bar at whatever the hell he wanted, and it would get funded. I can guarantee it. BDA by itself would probably get some pile of money necessary.
Oh, I wish there was a way I could get paid for P99. It's retarded. We had a player on Red offer something similar, but he was the only person that was behind it.
And oh, was it the Jew?
Yes.
And that's all I know about him, is the Jew.
Yeah, Heartbrand. He, I'm probably going to have to edit that little bit out. But, yeah, that's why I said make sure you have you know, the names of as many guild leaders that support it on there. Because if it's just one person, no one's going to give a shit. But if it's a bunch of guild leaders representing many peoples, then it would probably be much more worth reading to Rogan and Nobog than just one person being like, I'll pay you to do this. Because money alone isn't really an incentive to us.
I know it's not an incentive, but as in just take the cash. I mean, that's obviously not what we're going for. I actually care about this server.
Right. I know you do. You wouldn't be passionate about shit if you didn't care.
Right, and I care about the little guy, as you know, as sad as that may sound. But there's, like I said, the large chunk of the people on this server don't want to play like Ivy and TMO. So if I can have a platform to help that playstyle come forward, then I'd, you know, try and promote that. If there was an entire server like that, that would be even better.
I don't know if you're right or wrong, but like I said, you write it up and I'll make sure Rogan reads it.
I mean, I even had one of your guides on Blue, not on Blue, on Velius, that said that that he would probably step forward in a GM role if it was necessary. Because we even talked about having a council of the guild leaders that would deal with discipline issues.
You guys could do that here.
No, we can't, because there's two guilds that say, fuck you, we do what we want.
Well, you could do it in Class R here.
Yeah, but we don't have those issues in Class R.
Well, that's very good. That's very
good. That's what I don't get also, is the fact that, you know, we're sitting here in Class R and we're busting our asses for the past year keeping this rotation together. And the only blips that we've had are Dol'Jannar and Genocidal Tendencies, both that were led by people missing parts of their brain. Otherwise, it's worked. It's worked perfectly. And so instead of just saying, hey, good job, guys, way to not play like jackasses. Because that's what it's been for the past 4 years, is that playstyle, the one that's been played by IB and TMO. Before it was IB, it was what, TR? Before that, it was what, Fishbait? Like, I don't know the exact history.
Was Fishbait IB?
I don't know who Fishbait was. I know they were one of the bigger guilds to start right when the server opened. Like, I don't know exact... I don't know exact timeline, but I know they were big to start, I thought, because it was like, it was Dark Wind and Dark Ascension, and TMO was a baby guild, and it was TR, and then it turned into IB, or vice versa, whatever. All I'm saying is that type of playstyle, where it's been poop-socking and fighting and petitioning and people not getting along, it's been like that for this long.
Right.
So now we've divided those two personality types. You have the hardcore guys in Class C, you have the not hardcore guys in Class R, and we've got along. Like, the one thing you've been trying to tell players to do is get along, figure out your own rules, don't deal with petitions. I mean, you don't deal with petitions in TMO and IB anymore because they just trade off mobs over and over again.
Well, I don't care how they work their shit out. Something's on fire.
What you get for smoking?
I know, but I have a good nose. Hold on, I gotta deal with this. Fucking ashtray is one big-ass fire hazard. Alright, fire dealt with.
Anyways, all I'm doing is talking about Class R and the fact that we get along, and yeah, that doesn't really change anything. Cuke, say something important.
Hello.
You're not helping, Cuke. Say something super.
Tell me why your signature is the best signature on the forums.
I work day and night to ensure that it's the best. And I constantly thwart people who send me PMs and say that it offends them, and they use their ad blocking software to block it. So I have to go and host it again and paste it back in.
Oh, the hurdles you must overcome to bring your art to people.
The signature struggle is real.
The signature struggle is real.
Alright, so I will say something.
Did you change anything on the BDA boards? I don't know if I remember your sig on the BDA boards right now, if it's something new or old.
No, it's still the one I use on P99 forums.
Anyways, go, Cukes.
So I'm going to go back to the issue of poop socking. And I think it's one of those things that is just always going to happen, no matter what. I know you guys kind of came to this thing, we told everybody to agree not to do it, but I don't think no matter how much agreement there is, it'll ever go away. When people want something, they're going to wait for it, always. I mean, it's just how it is everywhere. Yeah. So I think instead of putting it on the player base and telling them, like, you should stop when no one is going to stop, you should just remove the source of the poop sock, which is variants. And it also happens to not be classic.
No, I mean, if you have the variants in, people are going to poop sock even harder because they're just going to sit and wait for that mob to spawn. Right. Or they're just going to show up 30 minutes ahead of time as opposed to this full 16 hours.
What we're looking at is basically abstinence versus reduction. Abstinence just doesn't work like anywhere. That shit never works anywhere. I mean, you tell 14-year-olds don't fuck, they're not going to listen to you. They're going to go and fuck. Same thing can pretty much be applied to poop socking. If you minimize it and just reduce it to the point where it's like, all right, 30 minutes to an hour, who gives a shit? Then it's not the 16-hour long, you just ruined your marriage and your job is going to fire you bullshit things.
Right. Or you just kill the FFA cycle entirely and then you'll have to worry about poop socking even existing.
I mean, I guess. It's another
guess. I mean, what do you mean you guess? I mean, that's what would happen.
Sure, yeah. I would agree. I mean, R's not. We still, R would still sit there for the 16-hour window and track, and same with C. But I think just killing variants just kind of fixes the whole damn thing.
Yeah, it's still going to turn into a sock, just mean more people are going to show up. Then you'll have every guild showing up waiting for the lottery when you know the exact time that's going to spawn.
Exactly. I know. I know that. Just said. That's but we have rules now. So variants, if I'm not mistaken, was originally introduced because you would have five or six guilds literally sitting on the spawn point, you know,
yes.
auto firing and shit like that.
It was awful.
And the reason they did that is because you had to get FTE. FTE was king, but nobody knew who had FTE. And I think that's why variants was put into place, to try and figure out who had FTE in a more easier way, I guess. But now that we have FTE shouts, now that we have rules saying you can only have two trackers at the spawn location, you can just extend the rules to say, all right, no more than 5 or 10 people total in the zone, remove variants, still have the shouts. I don't see what would be wrong with that.
Well, I think it's just going to turn into a lottery situation like that. Like you're
so
gonna
what?
Have,
EverQuest is a lottery system. The whole damn game is based off of a really bad random number generator.
I don't think the racing has to be like that, though. I mean, the racing should be enjoyable, not just, okay, there's 7 guilds lined up at this zone line. Let's go for it. Like, I don't like that. I don't
it's
think anybody should like
when
that.
Players don't know when the mob's going to pop. I've done it both ways. And maybe the variance should be shorter than it is, but I think some variants add some level of suspense. The bigger problem is poop socking. And unless... there's nothing we're going to be able to do to say don't poop sock, because they're just going to be like, well, I'm not poop socking. I'm just hunting real close by, and I'm just going to be hunting real close by for the next up to 16 hours. And like you said, if people want to do something, they're going to find a way to do it.
Yeah.
We need them to agree. Like, we need the guilds to just agree to stop doing it.
Like, again. Because you can't have that when there's two guilds at the top that said, no, fuck you, we do what we want. That's what I'm trying to tell you. They're not going to play ball, no matter what.
Well,
like this is the only way. This is the only way. That is not a good solution. Shrugging your shoulders and go, oh, that's how it is. Like, that doesn't fix it. Like, if you want the raid scene. Yes.
People agree not to poop sock.
Yes, it's easy. You kill the FFA tier and you put in full repops. Simple. Done. It fixes itself.
That might work with Class R, but that doesn't do anything for Class C.
Right, but let them fight over in Class C. If they want to play that playstyle, let them. Now the server has two options. Join Class C if you want to play that way. Stay in Class R if you want to play the other way.
I can say the same thing,
referring
though,
to the reduction of mobs.
I can say the same thing, though. You can do what you want to do within Class R, and if you don't want to deal with FFA, then don't deal with FFA.
It just defeats the purpose of having FFA, then.
The purpose of having FFA was essentially to balance out the mobs that were being taken away from the Class C guilds. Like, mathematically, that's what Rogan was explaining to us. was that he didn't want to take things away from Class C. He wanted to open up raid content to the smaller guilds. With the FFA in place, and with Class C probably getting 90% of the FFA mobs was the number he used, they're essentially getting the same amount minus a tiny, tiny bit.
And look, man, I'm worried about Velius. If we go back to the old system for Velius, which is what people are saying right now, like I think that's what Daribel said, was that when Velius drops, we're going back to just, you know,
Daribel balls that ball. Unless I agree to it, and if I don't agree,
no, but he's got to get right or no ball to agree to it. That's been the discussion, is that when Velius drops, the class systems go poof.
Well,
so then what are you going to have? Like this doesn't affect BDA so much, or it doesn't affect Taken so much, because we're going to get ours. Like, we know what we're doing. We're not idiots. We're going to go kill what we want to kill. And if, you know, TMO is going to be at the highest echelons of Velius, then, you know, we'll get what we want to get.
I can't say anything about Velius. All I can say is that nothing's set in stone about anything. And we listen to what players say. We don't always respond, but we do read the stuff. And I wouldn't be surprised if there's some kind of guild summit again, or if we just individually touch base with the guild leaders as we get closer to Velius. Because
Ziglark's going to already be an issue. Remember the fiasco that was Howlingstone Keys? Mm-hmm. Just imagine that for Velius going through trying to get to Cobalt Scar.
Yeah, no, it's going to be a pain in the ass. It's absolutely going to be a pain in the ass if it's just kind of like how Kunark was when Kunark launched. I absolutely hear what you're saying.
Yeah, so let's avoid that kind of problem now to not keep this toxic shit going on again to the next expansion. If there's a way to mitigate some of this drama ahead of time, let's try to head that off at the pass.
You guys need to not worry about Velius.
You're not my dad. I'll do what I want.
Well, I mean, you can, but the staff isn't going to do anything rule-wise regarding Velius until we at least have a rough, like, ETA on release. Because there's other... Like, I literally... Every minute that I have allocated for P99 stuff is busy. There is no free time. Monday nights, that's not P99 time. This is Sirkin fun time. If I wasn't doing this, I'd be in the other room watching Monday Night Football. There's zero chance that I would be doing P99 stuff right now.
Yeah, the Colts are crushing.
That's okay, though. Since I'm not streaming, I can actually use this monitor to check the score.
37-10. Oh, Maude Bradshaw, you son of a bitch.
New York's tight end is doing nothing, which is beautiful. Odell Beckham has, 78 yards, 2 catches.
Sports.
Sports!
Cucumbers, you gotta get in. Just find one sport, man. Just find one and just go with it.
You can get down on some soccer, bro. Like, that's pretty hipstery.
Yeah, I could get into that, I think.
What about hockey? I'm not a hockey fan, but I mean, I can... You can straight up fight in hockey.
You can't. Isn't hockey like NASCAR? No, nobody gives a shit about the actual sport. They just want to see people get hurt.
No, hockey actually has like some diehard people in it. Like, NASCAR is awful. NASCAR, no one should like NASCAR. Poland likes NASCAR, and Poland's awful.
The South.
That's how you know NASCAR. It's a terrible sport.
Got it.
Oh, I lived in Daytona Beach for 6 months, and I literally was a 5-minute drive from where they did the Daytona 500 track. And because I don't give a shit about racing, I had no idea that that was going to be a thing. And, like, I should have known, like, because the Daytona racetrack and Daytona 500, but I didn't. And there's a Chick-fil-A, like, right across the street from the front side of the track. And I used to go to that Chick-fil-A all the time. And then one day I go there, and it's just fucking people are everywhere in the street and parked and fucking in my Chick-fil-A. And the cars are loud as shit. And then a few weeks later, there's this thing called Hog Week with all these loud-ass motorcycles. And then a month after that, it's Spring Break with a bunch of fucking assholes. And it's just every month, there's something different. It's the absolute worst city and state in the entire country of America.
Why is it your Chick-fil-A? It's not yours. It's classy mentality thinking you own everything.
Here's the thing. I didn't know very many things or places or anything when I went to Florida, and that Chick-fil-A was like the center of my map. And so I needed to become very possessive because I had nothing. And so the Chick-fil-A was mine, the Burger King was mine, the Walgreens was mine, and everything else someone had to tell me how to get to.
Classy.
Oh, God damn it. I'm a real-life elitist, apparently.
Look, man, you've been exposed. Just fucking admit it.
Yep, my time in Florida ruined me. It really is the worst state. Don't go there.
So people want us to go on some bum fights thing. I'm not going to do that. The rest of these things are stupid.
Is that a stream or is that something happening in-game?
I don't know. This guy says we should duel on bum fights, and I'm not going to fucking duel a GM that has GM powers. That's obviously stupid.
That's really stupid, yeah. It's really stupid.
Not that I can't duel. I actually know how to do that.
Yeah, no. When people duel me, I tell them they would lose. I'm like, you don't want to duel me. You'll lose. Because you know what? I'm a GM. I won't death touch you. I don't need to. I have shit from fucking... Let's just say my stuff's not classic. I got Demiplane of Blood shit running around.
Yeah, I don't even know what that stuff is. When I played on Sullen's Ek, I never even made it to 60.
I have like 6,000 hit points on Sirkin.
I PvP'd all day. So I don't know. I didn't even know how to raid until I started playing on P99. Oh, never raided in my entire life.
That's one thing I really miss about live servers that we just don't have here is I guess you kind of have it on Blue, but specifically Red Server I'm talking about, is back on Valen's Ek, we had like low or mid-level PvPers who like really didn't care about leveling. Like they stayed at like level 30 to 40, and that was their thing.
So are we just talking about Wiggo or what?
Him, I know there was White Rose and somebody else on Valen's Ek and Butcher Block.
Any of the Shanks or what?
Oh my god. They were blue team though. I was blue team. I didn't worry about them.
Yeah, I was blue team with me and my friends. We had a tiny little guild called, I want to say we were Forbidden. All of our guys in real life they started as fruits. There was blueberries and cranberries and cherry and all those guys. Orange was a bard.
Was blueberries a druid?
Blueberries was a druid. I still know that guy.
I totally knew that guy.
Yeah, I still know that guy. We're still friends.
Funny. Yeah, I actually really liked the teams on Valen's Ek because it made it so like I was pals with people in guilds that I would have never been pals with, but just because we were both, you know, blue team and I physically couldn't attack them, they might get the occasional like joking haha you're lucky I can't get you kind of thing.
If y'all are gonna do a new team server, which I guess is what's in the works at some point in the future, like you can't have a level range. Having a level range fucks everything up. It's terrible. Sullen's Ek
level range. You have assholes like Abacab running around ganking level sixes.
Well, find a way to not let that happen then.
It's
but
called a level range.
The level range is terrible. Then you have immune healers and stuff. It's awful. Sullen's Ek was the best PvP playstyle of all time.
What we need is code that if you get on aggro essentially by healing or buffing or whatever, then it flags you for PvP. So basically, you can either stay the fuck out of the fight, or if you do get involved via healing or buffing or attacking, whatever, I guess you couldn't attack. But you know what I mean, like healing, the IMI stuff. Then it would flag you for PvP, and then you could just kill that person.
It's a good idea. I mean,
yeah, if it's not exploitable, but I feel like there's a way to deal with that where you heal somebody once and then get the hell away or something.
Well, I mean, if it's just one heal and get away, it might not be too big of a problem, but I would just send somebody after that person.
Yeah, what if it's a CH? Then what?
Well, here's the thing. You just got to keep in mind when you see two people that you might have to actually kill two people. Because that healer's there, and that healer might heal his buddy, and you better be ready for that. But if he does, you know, he can't just stand there and heal without any risk to his own body. He has to do it while dodging your offensive maneuvers.
I don't even think I'd play a caster on red at this point. The fact that you can't duck out of spells seems very, very...
Isn't that the stupidest shit?
Penalizing. Because I played a wizard on live. That's all I did on live, was just blow people up as a wizard, because I was a terrible PvP-er, apparently.
Hey, I'm the same way. I blew people up as a mage. Send pet, blow people up. That was it.
Well, I ran around with an enchanter everywhere I went. We were a duo. We'd be in the same room, and we'd mezbomb people, which is the most unfair way to kill people you could possibly do.
Oh, no. All is fair in EQ PvP.
You see that bard zooming by at 900 mile an hour? Grab that motherfucker with Rapture. All right, Lure of Ice, Rapture. Lure of Ice, Rapture. Okay, he's dead.
Hold on. Catherine's bumping the petition that was never made. I want to see this.
Look, it's going to say exactly what I told you, which was TMO aggroed Sev with their tracker. They were the first one to have bad FTE or whatever.
Oh, well, why is this flag for somebody not me? Is the better question, actually. Well, Catherine, I will say that if you notice the name in parentheses on that petition title, it's not my name, which is why it didn't come up when I pulled the petitions that have been assigned to me. But I'll take a look at it anyway, because I feel like it probably should have been assigned to me.
Let's look at this right now. Go. Read the petition. Let's go.
I can't do petitions on... Well, we're technically not live, are we?
No, we're not live. That means it's in recording. Go.
Hold on, I'm pulling it back up.
If you look at Skype chat, there's additional information for you.
Oh, Hoku sent a petition as well?
Yep.
Interesting.
I just saw his first message. It's very true. I've had 3 females tell me that in the last...
Oh, no. Don't get that shit twisted. I can tell you the fucking straight up deals on that, and that is not true. Flip flop that shit.
I had 3 different people tell me he's kind of crazy.
That is totally true.
No, I'll give you the
100% true.
I'll give you
witnessed it myself.
I'll give you the creepy as fuck line keeps, promise. We will have this conversation. I will clear the name.
You can't clear that name with me. That name is forever soiled.
Oh, god damn it. I'm gonna have to find out what I did to my XSplit settings, because I'm pretty sure that's why stream is fucking up.
Look, man, Narova ran a stream for 24 straight hours.
Do you know if he runs OBS or XSplit?
I don't know. Maybe you should ask him. You have him in your chat right now. Chat him up.
Let's see if he's still here. He is.
Touchdown for the Giants, Larry Donnell. Good dick.
Are you serious right now?
That just happened.
Oh, I hate your face.
All up in your mouth. And that was a push-off, too. That should not have been a touchdown.
Where? Throw flags, people.
Well, I mean, he got away with it because he didn't extend his arms all the way. He gave it a little push.
Such bullshit.
Go team! Crush the other team soundly!
I mean, you live in New York. You should root for one of these teams that is in New York.
Oh my god, damn it. It's okay, though. Beckham still has more. Beckham has done things. Oh, please just give him a touchdown. That would be glorious. Oh my god, it's 17-40?
Yeah, the Colts are good.
Alright, New York, just throw the ball. Just throw the ball. Just not to Donald. Oh, that's alright, though. It's alright. I'm up by 18? I'm up by 18. So this guy, he needs, like, 3 touchdowns or 2 in yards or something.
There you go. Trouble says use OBS because it's a much lighter program. Do that.
I hate OBS.
Well, I mean, I trust Trouble. He knows what he's doing.
Nor. God damn it.
Did you finish the petition? Like, what are we doing?
Oh, I'm talking to Norova real quick.
That's not a petition.
No, it's not, but it's XSplit stuff. Can you please shoot me a PM on the P99 forms? Alright, petition. Blah, blah, blah. There will also be a petition sent in from IB with their information. TMO Mage, Linksys, Guy Legal, FTE, trained him into IB trackers and ours and wiped us all out. TB then proceeded to kite Sev around for a while, take him COM, then EJ, blah, blah, blah. Attempted to kill him regardless. Take and followed your instructions and respected the FTE yellow text regardless the circumstances and ended up pulling out a clutch kill regardless of TMO's manipulation of the rules installing. IB in this situation was taken out of competition due to TMO's manipulation. I did warn of this situation in my previous petition to mages sitting on the spawn point of dragons and that this was going to happen. The clarity that we were given from Sirkin was, if they were not on the spawn point at the time of the pop, then no harm, no foul. Pretty much, yeah, because time cop. And then there's a quote from me that starts off with, holy fucking nerds, so you know it's going to be good. Well, we didn't
don't sit on spawn, blah, blah, blah.
Pretty much. Well, we didn't agree with this. We had to accept it. Now TMO has done exactly what Sirkin has said is breaking the tracker of FTE rule. Regardless, they tried to stall and counter and still tried to kill it. This is cut and dry. They manipulated and violated the rules. Here are my logs, which we don't accept as evidence anyway, so whatever. And a screenshot to match up with them. I died quickly due to the mess they created illegally by FTE and Sev. IB will be providing fraps in their own petition of them taking Sev to EJ's own line and attempting to kill Sev regardless of their violations. Do 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 do.
So it sounds like you should drop the hammer.
Hold on.
For once in your life.
I've dropped more hammers than any other GM on this fucking server.
Your name's not Uthgard, liar.
I've dropped way more hammers than Uthgard, buddy pal. Uthgard was a GM over 700 people for like 8 months.
Uthgard suspended me for one day, like when I was level 10.
I give people 24-hour suspensions all the time, not to level 10s, because the level 10's never going to do anything to fucking get me to suspend them. But I guarantee you I've suspended more people than anybody else. Hi there. Do you remember the Sev last weekend where TMO had a mage on the spawn point and dumb shit occurred and then Taken got the kill? Alright, what is this log shit? Starts with that, shows the FTE, blah, blah, blah. Oh, pictures.
Visual learner.
Woo, pictures!
Well, here's the thing. Any asshole can edit the text before they post the log. And so I
God damn it, dude. You know how tiring it is to hear that shit? You need fraps with 7 different angles to get anybody with anything on the server. It's annoying as shit.
Listen, you just sending me this... Here.
Yeah, I'm sure you're going to show me a screenshot, and I'm going to be like, that's not conclusive at all.
There. That's a log. And you that's I've changed some stuff around, but and when you go through it, if you actually go through and read it, I'm sure you'll find it. But my point is, any asshole can put anything they want in a grouping of text and say it's logs. She doesn't need to send any of these logs because she has an actual screenshot.
I'm just saying that if you tell everybody you need to compete harder, and then you make it so impossible to try and figure out how to catch people... It's a non-combo, man. Again, another reason to entirely get rid of the FFA tier to prevent this shit. You'd save yourself so much time. You'd have so much more room for activities.
You understand that everything you say in regards to getting more mobs to Class R is going to be taken with a grain of salt because of the clear and obvious bias of you being in Class R.
Except I don't really give a shit. If I wanted more mobs in Class R, then I wouldn't be having a rotation and being spearheading it. If I wanted mobs for me, I'd be busting ass in every mob that I saw that I could have an opportunity to kill.
I hear you. Hold on one second. Why? Oh my god. I hate Umbrella so much sometimes.
Hey, get in line.
Come on, Hokushin, use your words. I see your pencil. Oh, here we go. 10:15. No, no, no. That's from like fucking 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago. Unless you update it after. You? No, 11:01. Maybe. Maybe. What is this? What are you showing me, nerd? I don't even know what mob this is. Oh, I guess this is Sev. Oh shit. But this has got to be a different Sev because there's no taken on this one.
And look, every single Sev sucks like this. If only there was a way to fix Sev? The situation.
Why does Sev suck so bad? What
green scales. It's the only fucking mob drops crops green scales. Everything
what
else.
What about the encounters making it? Like, is it just that people are sitting in the middle of that crater? Is like, what's the? Like, I know people want the dragon, but what's the?
It's one of the easiest mobs to sock. It's that, it's Talondor, it's Fatadar, not as much as Fatadar because you're out in the goddamn ocean, but you get the idea. There's plenty of ways to do this, but and Sev is one of the easier ones.
Like that they're socking the absolute shit out of it?
They sock, well, Sev's one of the highest socking ones because it has the green scale. Everybody needs green scales. And you know what? You know what's funny about this? Class C's was bagged out today after the repop. And Sev was classy. Classy didn't go after it. So that means when it hit 6 hours in 1 second, it was free-for-all. So any of the Class R guilds that weren't bagged out, you know, they were going to be going for Sev immediately. 4 Class R guilds showed up to go chase that mob. Like, they could have sat there and waited and jab-spanned like jackasses, but 4 guilds worked together to find out and a better way to do the encounter. They agreed on some simple rules right off the bat. They fought over it, and you know the one guild won the race. Whatever.
Right.
Took 10 minutes to figure out.
Let's see. Give me 1 second. I'm writing something to Nerova real quick. Blah blah blah. Cause that's fine.
All right, I'll ask the hard-hitting questions while Sirkin's doing his thing. Chess Rockwell of Bregan the Earth. Will Bregan the Earth be going Class C?
No. Next question.
Why not?
Why are we not going to go Class C? Because we don't want to deal with TMO and IB.
But Pixels.
What if they left? What if they were just like raptured off of the server?
Then, if they were raptured off the server, I would try to implement a rotation for the entire server. So everybody can see Pixels.
So you still wouldn't move into Class C even if there was no other guilds in Class C?
I mean, obviously, if there's a vacuum in VP, then other guilds will move in there. And if that was what happened, that's what happens. But I would try to move everybody to Class C at that point, and everybody could see VP if they wanted to see it. We're 4 years in an expansion. Are you really saying that still 2 guilds should control the high-end zone? Like, what happens in Velius? How long should I wait in Velius before I get to go see Sleeper's Tomb?
Until the end of time.
That, I don't know. I do know that if somebody wakes the sleeper to be a dick, I'm going to be real mad about it. Real mad. And I know there's been rumblings and whispers of people planning on doing that.
I mean, with 12 people, you can go kill Master of the Guard, the Progenitor, and who's the other fuckface in Sleeper's Tomb? The three mini-bosses. Cukes, we did that
the final Arbiter or whatever?
Yeah, that guy. You can kill those three mobs with two groups, basically. So are there going to be people sitting there socking those because it's a free primal drop every single time? Like, that's going to be absurd.
I 100% agree with you.
People want it. They're going to wait for it.
I mean, obviously, we probably would have been in VP if it wasn't the fact that y'all decided to let it be Train Fest for 2 years.
Well, to be fair, VP should have never been released when VP was released. That's why it was Train Fest, because the pathing is fucking stupid.
No, it was Train Fest because y'all had a no CSR policy, which let them go fucking buck wild.
We had a no CSR policy because the zone wasn't finished, and we only released it to shut them up. No, we told them it wasn't finished, and we told them if we release it, it's going to be no CSR because we're not going to deal with the bullshit that comes from the fucking lack of problems.
Except no CSR meant no GM help as far as, okay, my corpse is rotting, or we can't get out from under this mob and that kind of crap. Not, you know, train with impunity because that's how it works.
Maybe on live that's what it meant, but here on this server, that is absolutely not what it meant. I had addressed many threads with people saying exactly that.
Which is dumb.
Maybe it is, but on P99, no CSR includes trains. Video and audio encoding. Because I fucked my shit up. Because you know why? I saw somebody else streaming, and their fucking stream looked really nice and crisp and real nice graphically. And I asked them, like, oh, what are you running? And they told me their computer setup and their internet speed. And all my shit is better than theirs. All of it. And it was like, oh, man, my settings must be fucked. And I'll just tweak these a little bit, and then I'll be crisp and awesome. And I just broke everything. I broke it all.
Nicely done.
Do you know the difference between CBR and VBR?
Nope. Don't stream. Don't know.
It's like constant bitrate versus variable bitrate.
Nerds.
Oh man, that might be a thing. Look at you.
So, I don't know anything about streaming, but I'm going to make the assumption if you want to preserve bandwidth, you might want to go with variable. And it might give you better quality in some situations. I don't know.
All right, do we have anything else to talk about? Because, at some point I got to go to bed.
No, I think we're good. I think we're good. I've got nothing else. I feel like we're just circling over the same topics at this point.
Nah, it was basically Festivus. I just aired shit out.
Well, we'll have to do it again. I'll find some other cause for people to throw money at.
Look, man, you give us a fucking split server, there will be money flying at that thing. I can guarantee you at least 9 of the Class R guilds, I want to say, maybe 8 of the Class R guilds would support that. I think the only people that didn't like the idea, I think Arg said it was a bad idea, but I know, I thought we agreed that Arg was out of his mind sometimes. And I want to say that Clokey didn't like it, but...
Cucumbers didn't like it.
But Clokey also thinks that Shinko would be good in Class R, so... What the fuck does he know?
I'm real curious to see what exact... Because I know... I have to believe that Shinko has a bigger endgame than the obvious, which is trying to disrupt Class R. Because if that was his endgame, he'd probably try to mask that a little better, I feel. And so it makes me wonder if that's not his main motive, what he's actually trying to do.
It's his main mode.
Well, I know it pisses you off the most, but...
It's not that it pisses me off. What pisses me off is that you guys tacitly signed off on it.
Yeah, we're not going to tell somebody they can't be in Class R just because they used to be in Class C.
He's still in Class C! He's not used to. He's still in Class C.
He hasn't played in forever ago. No, like
bullshit. He's on IMBA all
like
the time.
2 weeks, 3 weeks.
No, he's still in Class C. He's still on the TMO roster. He actively raids. He shows up to VP shit. He's an active member of TMO.
He was MIA for a good long while.
No, he wasn't.
Oh, I'm thinking of Sloan, aren't I? Oh, shit.
Yeah, you jackass. Sloan.
Sorry, that's my bad. Oh, Shanko. Shanko, I yelled at Sloan. Sloan's the only player I've ever screamed at. I lost my shit on him.
He's kind of insufferable, too, so.
He was just being purposely dense, and I had no more patience for it. Yeah. I don't know what Shanko's thing is. But here's the thing. Like I said before, if it's just a guild of Class C alts, they're not going to be in Class R. We're not going to let them use Class R to gear up their other characters. That's retarded. But if it's a bunch of non-Class C people, if it's actual new players and players from existing R guilds that want to join his guild, I'm not going to tell them that they can't be part of Class R. However, if it's just a bunch of alts and Class C people, then I'm not even going to let them fucking pretend to ever be a part of Class R.
All right, well, get your hammer out, because that's exactly what it is.
Well, it's out. Like I said, I know about it. I'm keeping eyes on it. I was out of town Tuesday to Saturday, and I don't do anything on Sundays. So, I mean, technically, I've been out of town for almost a week. But, I'm going to watch it. Darebill's going to watch it. You know me is going to watch it. And if they're just trying to funnel loots out, I'm going to ban the absolute shit out of Shanko and his officers. And I'm going to disband his guild. And I'm going to never let him lead a guild again on this server.
I'm glad this is going to be recorded.
Oh,
so I'll have it on
it's
tape.
It's going to be on YouTube as well.
I know. I'm just going to make sure that it's recorded. So whenever you say, well, blah, 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 I can come back and point at this.
That's absolutely, that's one of the reasons I do the stream, so you have things to point at. That's me looking out for you guys. Because I care.
You look out at shit.
I look out. I am like your lighthouse, and you are all my little boats. And I don't want you to crash into the rocks, or into each other, or into me. Accept my light into your life. Let it guide you to safety and warmth and shelter and all the things you would find at a port near a lighthouse.
Except two boats get 80% of the light and the other 10 boats
no,
get maybe 20% of the light
love.
Sometimes.
The light is not pixels. The light is
whatever.
My love. And you guys.
Your
all,
metaphor's stupid.
You have my
you
love.
You should feel bad. Me.
I think you're all unique individual snowflakes, and I love you.
That was stupid.
You're stupid, and your snowflakes are stupid, and I hate you.
It's not my fault. You're making stupid metaphors.
Oh, my analogies are amazing and priceless. People should stand in line to hear what comes out of my mouth sometimes. How do you feel about that? No comment there.
Not a fan.
Just have a stroke. Oh. Well. But yeah. I think that might be about it. I got nothing else. So unless you, Chester, you cucumbers, have anything.
I'll be back with raise another 10K.
A+. Chess, thank you very much for coming on. I know it's not your favorite thing to do, but you're definitely a man of your word, and you stuck to it, and you came on. And so, it was a pleasure having you here. Cucumbers, thank you for not letting anything get too out of hand, and for adding your little titbits. You guys, I hope it won't cost $10,000 to get you back, but maybe I'll find some other way to... coerce you into coming back. Do you have any like final things about BDA recruitment or a webpage where they can go to apply to the guild or anything of that nature?
Brigandareth.net. Check the BDA thread on the guild section of the P99 forums, or talk to any officer that is online in BDA. If you need to find one, ask any BDA member, they can find you one.
Just don't go to Scary, he's useless.
Sorry, Scary. Cucumbers, do you have anything to plug besides that sexy signature?
Nope.
A plus. Go look at Cucumber's signature. It will make your day better. I'm Sirkin. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you guys next Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern. Have a wonderful, wonderful night. I'm looking for Skype because I'm trying to put you guys on hold so I can play an outro video. And now that I'm realizing we're offline, I don't need to do that. I can just add the video later in editing. So
good job.
So yeah, that's going to be a thing. Bye, everyone.